permission to propose. Sir, you are married. You are married and you have kids. Marriage decision, I have granted you permission to propose. I look forward to the royal wedding that will soon follow. Okay, anyway. Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today's video is a mod review and I am very excited to show you guys this mod. It is the Royal Family mod by Kiera Sims 4 Mods. And the reason I am so excited for this is because if you don't know, I have a Royal Family Let's Play series on my channel. I've been doing this series for years. I've been playing Royal Sims for years. As this video is being posted, the Royal Family mod is available for early access to Kiera's patrons on her Patreon page. It will be available for the public to download on August 8th, 2021. If you don't know how to download mods, I will link a video tutorial below for you to learn how to do so. Mods in CC cannot be downloaded on console. They are only available to download for Mac and PC users. Now, before we begin, I just want to mention something. Some of you guys might know that there is a royalty mod, which is a different mod by Lazy Neef, and I did a review of that mod a little less than 2 years ago. Now, there are differences in both the Royal Family mod by Kier Zerk that we are seeing today and the royalty mod by Lazy Neef. There are also a few similarities. I don't currently have the royalty mod by Lazy Neef installed in my game because I wanted to just show you guys the Royal Family mod in this video, but I will add it back into my game at the end of this video and we will see if the two can work together because I know some people had questions about that. And we can also talk about the similarities and differences between the two if you are debating on getting one or the other, or if you want to use both, you can kind of see how they work or if they work. I'm actually not sure. I will find out at the end of this video. The first thing I'm gonna do is go over all the information for this mod. This mod comes with a lot of stuff. There's a lot that went into this, so it is a pretty lengthy post, but just bear with me. It does say, do not download this mod without reading the entire post. So that's what we're going to do. So this is the Royal Family mod post directly from Kiera's Patreon page. She has some information about any updates she made up here. And then it says that the required game packs for this mod are City Living and Get Famous. So it will not work correctly unless you have those two packs. Other requirements is the Work From Home Pie menu, which you will have to click on to download separately. There are several things that you are going to have to download separately in order to get the full experience from this mod. So you would just click on the link that she puts and she'll let you know if you do need to download it separately. And then you will just go to the post and just scroll all the way down. And the mod also requires the XML injector. So she does have the attachment to download that mod as well. And then the Work From Home Pie menu mod that you can download and put in your mods folder. So let's go back to the original post. So it says, FYI, before you can do anything, your Sim must have the King or Queen cast trait. All other traits before, like Prince and Princess, should be removed. They will now conflict with this mod as those titles are now anointed. You can find the King and Queen traits here. So we did not see this with the Pie menu mod, the Work From Home Pie menu mod that she had linked before, but I just wanna let you guys know because this is the case for all the traits that you have to download, the events, the aspirations. So you have to go to this separate post that she links. Now, Kiera has made a lot of mods. She has a ton of traits that she's made, and just a ton of careers, all this stuff. So this whole folder, I'm gonna scroll all the way down. This whole folder that she links at the bottom here, you are going to have to download the zip folder if you want to get only the traits that are required for this mod. If you want all of them, I believe you just download the package file. So you see package file there. And then if you don't want all of them, you're going to just download the zip file. So I'm just gonna show you real quick. I already have this downloaded in my game, but I just wanna show you like what you're gonna have to find. So I'm opening up the folder that I downloaded for the traits, and all of them are included in here. The only ones that you're going to need are the King trait. So you will have to find it. It is in alphabetical order. So the King trait and the Queen trait. Again, you can download all of them if you would like to, but if you just want the specific ones, just put those two in your mod folder. You can just click and drag them to your mod folder or copy and paste it in there. So that's for the traits. And then it says the first thing to know is understanding the differences between the four royal icons. You can, of course, change it how you like, but this is how I'm going with it.
So the first icon is the crown that represents the head of the monarchy, which is only for the king, queen, prince consort, or queen consort. The head of the monarchy, the heir to the throne, or the spouse of the monarchy to the heir. The second one is for Sims born into the royal family. These titles I have used crown prince, crown princess, prince, princess, earl, duke, and lord. The third one is a double crown for a Sim that is married into the royal family. Titles used with this image are duchess, countess, and I would include duke here, but if a man marries into the royal family, he may be given a dukedom if the queen or king allows that title. So there are some different rules. You guys will see when I go into game, I have like created my own world, so I make my own set of rules. It looks like Kira went with something a little bit more traditional for the mod. I'm not sure if that will change in the future, we will see, but that's what she decided to go with. Then the fourth icon is for a title that is used as an honorary title or lower level royal title. You may see this title next to the lady title. And then the next section is for the titles. These titles can be granted to Sims under the pie menu. The only titles that cannot be granted are king and queen, because those are the traits that you put on the Sim in CAS. So we will see all this when we go in game. And then it says, when a title is granted, you will see a notification and there are buffs for both Sims. I won't read all this because again, we're gonna go in game after this and we can just read it from there. Sims will also gain a red tooltip text over their head. So you guys see like queen consort here. It says titles may disappear when a holiday occurs or you host an event. So you will have to add titles back. So just keep that in mind. These options will show up for non-king, prince consort, queen, and queen consort Sims. So these are the options that she was talking about for that, which is ask to remove royal title and request no titles for kids, which I think is pretty cool that she added that in there. An in-text notification will appear with a decision, which I don't know if it's random what the monarch's decision is or if it is based on their relationship with the Sim that asks, but that is cool that it is a feature. And then next is the royal family career, which is a separate download, so she has the link to download that. There is a new career for your Sim to join if they are a member of the royal family. You will join the branch based on your title and you will have tasks to complete. Your Sim must be joined into the career to see agenda and permission interactions. The royal family represents the monarch of Sim Nation, which I was gonna get into this later, but I can just bring it up now. If you're familiar with my royal family series, I actually have seven, technically eight kingdoms, but seven kingdoms. I have a royal family of Windenburg, which is the main family that we are going to see, that we're gonna try this mod out on in this video. But I also have like a kingdom of Willow Creek and a kingdom of Voice of Springs and all that stuff. So this is a downside for me specifically just because of my way of how I play my game. Others might not mind at all, but it does, like there, it seems like there's only registering as one kingdom and it says it's Sim Nation. I'm assuming we can still add all this stuff for multiple monarchs, so that's fine. It's just that the notifications and stuff will say like they're the monarch of Sim Nation. Hopefully that is changed in the future. That is something I would like to see. But yeah, anyway, just wanted to bring that up. So yeah, they represent the monarch of Sim Nation. A monarchy is a form of government in which a person, the monarch, is head of state for life or until abdication. The royal family's agenda is to carry out official engagements throughout the global Sim Nation. And then engagements include national festivals, garden parties, receptions, and other formal visits. Now, when you first enter the career, you are a royal etiquette learner. It does say you can cheat to, you can use a cheat to skip this level if you are the king or queen. You can promote with like, there's MC Command Center, there is UI cheats, you can do either to promote, but you can also just use the in-game cheats as well. You will use the royal duty event and gain some charisma skills. Once promoted, you can choose the level of your title. Here is an example below. So once you've gotten to level 2 of the career, it will give you this option and you choose what you are, like based on your title. So for example, my queen would pick the queen one. And then it says, once in a career, you will give speeches, donate to charity, and promote the royal family agenda by using interactions under the agenda category. Other royal event tasks uses the royal duties event. I recommend you attend with a king or queen unless you are the king or queen. And then the next section is lot traits, which are a separate download as well. There is a royal castle lot trait. So it says home of a royal family member and royal home, which is a home that belongs to the head of the monarchy. I think it might say something different in my game. I don't remember it because I took a peek, but I'll show you guys everything when we go in game. I thought it said that it belongs to a member of the royal family as well, but we'll have to go see. And then I believe you get certain moodlets if you are on that lot based on the lot trait. So again, those are separate to download and you have to click there to download. And then there are patronages. There are various patronages that the king or queen can appoint to their family members. The ones that are included are patron of the art society, animal society, education association, angling club, gardening society, photographic society, royal academy of music, royal food trust, San Myshuno festivals, starlight accolades, ambassador of Sulani, head of the royal family charity, patron of medical research, and patron of friends of the elderly. And then there are different activities you can do depending on what you are a patron of. And then next is agenda. And the things you can do on the agenda, so this is in the social pie menu, but you can talk about royal family history, promote royal family agenda, discuss future engagements, commit to charity work, and give royal patronage update. The next is permissions. Ask for permission to propose, and this is for non-king and queen sims. That sim who asks will get a notification if they are allowed to propose. And then another thing you can do is ask to become a non-working royal, which is cool that that is added as well. So kings, prince consort, queens, and queen consorts cannot use this interaction, but any others can, and a decision will be made. The king or queen can also gift other royal sims a home or lease them a home. I think that's really cool. I'm not sure exactly how that works in game. We will have to see. I don't know if it's just an interaction, but the difference is that Kira explains is for leasing, you can lease them a royal home, but they don't technically own the home, the person that she leases it to. And then you can gift a royal residence, which is like if the prince or princess got married and you want to gift them a home as a wedding gift, you can do that. And then other interactions are under news, and it says this category is used for sims to update the head of the monarchy, other family members, or the public on things happening in their life. There are two interactions that will always be under this category. Give royal charity update and give royal family news update. But there will also be other options. Announce royal baby, announce royal engagement, and announce divorce from spouse. Next section is events, and those will be a separate download. The events included are a royal wedding event, a coronation, a garden party, and there's also a royal duties event that is already available. And what she means by that, I want to clear any confusion because I was kind of confused. I thought that it meant that the royal duties event was already included in the whole mod download. So it's actually because she had already made a royal duties event before she came out with this mod. So that's what she means by it was already included. You still have to download it like you download all the other ones as well. The next section is computer interactions, which is host meeting with patronage group. So sims who have a patronage can use this computer interaction and it will leave you with a focused buff for 6 hours. This interaction is found under computer, career, and under my work from home pie menu. And then the last thing is aspirations. So two new aspirations were added, royal family member and royal family monarch. And those are also a separate download. And then at the bottom of the post, you will find the attachment to download the actual mod. So you'll just go ahead and download that and put that into your mods folder. All right, so we are now in Create a Sim with my royal family of Windenburg. They are one of my 8 royal families. And the Windenburg royal family that you see is my current family as of season 2, part 73 of my royal family series. Also, if anyone is wondering, I have a Pinterest board with all of my custom content that's categorized in different sections. And there you will find the links to the custom content that you see, like the crowns and dresses and hair, skin details and all that. I also have some custom content videos on my channel and they have their own separate playlist. The links to my Pinterest board and the playlist will all be in the video description below, along with everything else. Every link that you need will be in the video description below. Yeah, anyway, okay, so we are now in Create a Sim and the first thing we're gonna do, because Kiris did say on her page that you can't do anything until you have given the king or queen trait to your sim. So we are going to go ahead and do that. This is Queen Amira. She is going to be, okay, so this does take up one of the trait spaces. However, there are mods that you can use to, like I know MC Command Center, they have a way that you can add more than 3 traits for your sim. So you can use MC Command Center for that if you would like to. The queen trait is here under the little sailboat under lifestyle. And then for aspiration, I'm gonna go ahead and change her aspiration since this mod did come with two new ones. So they are under family. Yes, they're under family. So we have the royal family monarch, which is what I'm gonna give to Amira. It says, as the royal family monarch, you are the head of the royal family. You dedicate your life to carry out state and national duties, as well as carrying out important work in the areas of public and charitable service and helping to strengthen national unity and stability. So I'll go ahead and give that to her. Now we also have her husband, Prince Consort Jabari. So I'm not going to give him the king trait because he's the prince consort. Amira will actually anoint him as the prince consort once we go in game. So I'm gonna give him the other one, which was royal family member. And it says, as a royal family member, you will work to support the monarchy to carry out state and national duties, as well as carrying out important work in the areas of public and charitable service and helping to strengthen national unity and stability. So we'll go ahead and give that to him. That's all we need to do and create a sim, and we'll go ahead now in game. All right, we are now at the royal family of Windenburg's palace. The kids are at school, but it's 6 a.m., so I don't know why they're at school because they're not supposed to be there yet, but that's fine. So Amira, she is going to give her husband Jabari the prince consort title. As you guys can see, I have always put their title in front of their name. So I have like Prince Jabari, it's supposed to be Prince Consort Jabari, but Prince Jabari, and I do this with all of my royals. I do this with anyone who has a title. Oh, also ignore this teleporter statue back here. Let me go ahead and get rid of that actually. Okay, we're good. But with this, you guys will see the titles. I could replace it, but there's not titles for everything that's included in this mod that I have for all of my nobles. You guys will see in a bit. We're going to go to the royal family option, and we're gonna go to titles, and we're going to say anoint prince consort title. And just so you guys know, so we have prince consort, prince, princess, queen consort, lord, lady, earl, duke, duchess, crown princess, crown prince, and countess. And what I have that I don't see in this mod, Marchioness and Marquise, and then Baron and Baroness. So hopefully those will be added later, we shall see. But we're going to go ahead and give Jabari the Prince Consort title. All right, so Amira is here. She's giving him a kiss on the cheek, and she is going to anoint him as Prince Consort. She's sitting him down to do this. He's been Prince Consort for years. They've been married for years, but now he's getting the title. But it says, royal title granted. To my beloved husband, the title of Prince Consort is now yours. Your official title is His Royal Highness Prince Consort. Okay, I do have to get rid of the prince in front of his name. Prince Consort, ignore the prince. Prince Consort Jabari Windenburg of Sim Nation. So it's supposed to be Prince Consort Jabari of Windenburg. But you will now represent the royal family at official events and are the highest ranking member of the royal family behind Her Majesty the Queen. But now Jabari has gotten the Prince Consort title. And then another thing we can do is make him a patron of, so let's see, patronages. Let's just do a point patron of Friends of the Elderly just for now, because I think that might be the easiest, one of the easiest ones to show you guys. Patronage appointed. A message from Her Majesty. I have appointed you as patron of the Friends of the Elderly group. You will represent our royal family by visiting nursing homes and spending time with elders. So we'll get to that in just a bit. I think to get like all the interactions that we want, we have to like make sure that they're in the career and that they have the title and everything. So we're going to have Amira join the royal family career, and I'm gonna need Jabari to do that as well. All right, so Jabari is first, so he is going to join the royal family career. And I did read all of this to you guys before, but we're going to have him join. And as we saw in the post, that they start on the first level as royal etiquette learner. So I am going to use a cheat to promote them, but I'll do that in a second. So Amira is next. We are going to do the royal family career. Yes, okay, milestone complete. Oh, okay, Queen Amira has completed royal family beginner. I totally missed that, beginner of the aspiration. But let me go ahead and promote both Amira and Jabari. So I am using UI cheats to promote them. I love this mod. It makes things very, very easy. So I'm just gonna right click on the crown here, and we're going to promote Amira, and then it'll give us the options for the branch to choose for her. And since she is the queen, I'm gonna put her in the queen branch. Yes, okay. Promoted to Her Majesty, Queen of, ignore some nation, Queen of Windenburg. Queen Amira has been promoted to Her Majesty, Queen of Windenburg. She will now make an additional 2,000 simoleons per hour for a grand total of 2,000 simoleons per hour. Her next shift is Friday at 12 p.m. Okay, and she only has to work 12 to 4. 2,000 simoleons an hour is a lot, so that's good. Okay, I actually thought they used to have like 4 billion simoleons. I don't know what happened to all of it. They were supposed to have more money than this. Let me actually do that now before I forget. Okay, they're good. That's a little bit more what I thought they had before. Now we are going to have Prince Jabari do the same, promote, and he is the Prince Consort. And yes, okay. Prince Jabari has been promoted to His Royal Highness Prince Consort of Windenburg. He will now make an additional 1,000 simoleons per hour for a grand total of 1,000 simoleons per hour. Now, I will say, I did see when the career branches were showing up that it says in the description that the Prince Consort was the husband of the queen. It would be nice to see it say that they're the husband of the monarch, because my heir of Willow Creek, the heir is supposed to be the future king, not the future queen, and his partner would be the Prince Consort. So I will also say that I would like to see Princess Consort in the future for an option as well, because if I have a queen that is married to a woman, then her wife would be the Princess Consort. So I did not see that as an option. I would like to see that in the future. Now we're gonna take a look at these aspirations. So it said, they have a child. I was like, we have to have another child? But she's already finished the first part of the aspiration. Next, she needs to gift or lease royal residences and then appoint royal patronages, which she did already do one of those, but I guess that was before she reached the aspiration. For Jabari's, he has to give 4 speeches and donate to 4 charities, or donate to a charity 4 times, and then start a royal patronage club, which we have already done so for him. For the patronage, he does get this moodlet. I didn't know if he was, I think we're supposed to have him volunteer. Yes, okay, it says he's supposed to volunteer at the nursing home, so Jabari's gonna go ahead and do that. So I'm going to wait until Jabari gets back from volunteering. And in the meantime, let's go ahead and give the lot trait. Now, before, when I was reading you guys the post and I was going over the lot traits, if you remember on the post, it said that the royal home, it said that it belonged to the monarch, I believe that's what it said. It does say in game that it is a home, the royal home is a home that belongs to the member of the royal family. And then the royal castle, it also says home of a royal family member. So this is, it's the palace, we'll say castle. So I'll go ahead and give that to them. And then the home, I would say, would be for, like, Amira has other siblings, so their households would get the royal home one instead. And then I will give the royal castle lot trait to, like, the royals. Some of them have multiple palaces, so I will put it on each of their palaces. And then they do get a moodlet that says royal castle from living in a royal castle. Castles are beautiful, and living in one is one of the best perks. So much history all around. And she does also get moodlets for granting titles and also for granting patronages. Okay, so Prince Consort Jabari is now back from volunteering. However, I don't see anything acknowledging the fact that he did the volunteering for his patronage. He has like the normal volunteering buff, so that's good. So I don't know if there was supposed to be something involving him volunteering, if there was any extra perk or bonus or anything for that. I know on the computer there is, if you go to career and work from home, and if you say host meeting with patronage group, I'm curious what this means and what you do. Okay, so he's at the computer now, so we're about to find out if, like, I don't know, because we haven't assigned anyone else to this group, to this patronage group, so I don't know if it, like, automatically does so, or if people come over, I'm not sure, so we're about to find out. You know, while Jabari is doing that, I should have Amira give the titles to her children. So we have the Crown Princess Alice May, she is the heir, and then we have Prince Cedric. So we are going to go to titles and anoint as Crown Princess for Cedric Prince. Okay, Amira is giving the titles now. The title of Crown Princess is now yours. Okay, now she's doing the same thing for Prince Cedric. And it says the same thing for Prince Cedric. He is His Royal Highness Prince Cedric of Windenburg. All right, now Jabari, are you still host meeting with patronage group? Is it a Zoom meeting? Is it a video conference, or do people come over? He's been on the computer for quite a while, So I'm not 100% sure. So I do want to wait and see if something is supposed to happen from hosting the meeting, like with Jabari. So I'm going to go ahead. I just teleported her younger brother, Amir's younger brother, Charles, here. So Charles is an earl. He's still a prince. He's Prince Charles, but he's the Earl of Windenburg. This is an example of something different that I do with my rules in my world. Okay, but she's giving Charles the title. He's got the earl title now. Pretty much says the same thing that the other one said. So there's supposed to be a permissions option. I do not see that. However, the lease royal residence was supposed to be in the permissions option along with the gift royal residence. I don't see the gifting one. I wonder if that is only a thing if they live with you, because I thought I saw it for Jabari. For the lease royal residence though, it didn't do anything the first time. Let's see. It says royal residence lease. I am granting you a royal residence located in the grounds of the royal palace. This home is leased to you by the crown estate. You have access to the royal residence as long as you want to live there. Okay. I mean, they were gifted a home like when he got married, but yeah, so I'm not sure why the gifting one isn't showing up, but I know that was mentioned on the post. All right, now Jabari is still hosting his meeting with the patronage group. I don't know why it's taking so long. I'm gonna have him exit out of there. I'm actually just curious. Did Charles leave already? No, he's still here. Okay, I'm going to control him. I have the control any sim mod, which I will link below as well. And I'm going to, okay, actions, control sim. So let me first save because I don't want him to actually do this, but I'm gonna have him ask Amira if he can be a non-working royal, because I'm just curious like how she answers, if it is random or if it, like, what she says. I'm just curious. Charles, you are going to, what's the royal family permissions, ask permission to propose. Sir, you are married and you have kids. Should I have him do it? Okay, I saved. I can just exit without saving after this. I want to see what happens because he's married. So why is that an option? Okay, he's asking now. Amira looks marriage decision. I have granted you permission to propose. I look forward to the royal wedding that will soon follow. It's already happened. Okay. So I don't know why that happened. Okay. Anyway, let me see. Let's go to royal family permissions. Asked to become non-working royal. Non-working royal decision. At this time, I will deny your request. Think about it a little longer because this is a big decision for you to become a non-working royal family member. I love that. That's awesome. Because it is a big deal, and I would think it would be a big deal for my family in this world too. That's cool. Okay, sorry, Charles. She approved the proposal thing, even though you're already married, but then denied the non-working royal request. So the last thing I will show you before we see if Lazy Neef's royalty mod will work in this is the events. And we're not going to do an event. I just want to show the events in here. Where do we go? In here for you guys. All right, so as we saw in the beginning, we have a coronation event, which is, it says in the description, it's time for the new king or queen to reign the throne. Throw a coronation to crown the next head of the royal family and to celebrate the important occasion. And then the other ones are royal duties. So the monarchy must deliver royal duties for the community. But when the monarchy is busy, members of the royal family support the monarchy, king or queen or both, in their many state and national duties, as well as carrying out important work in the areas of public and charitable service and helping to strengthen national unity and stability. And then we also have a garden party, which I'm actually so excited about because I would love to do one of these in the future. It says the king or queen welcomes guests to spend a relaxed summer afternoon in the beautiful gardens. Garden parties are an important way for the king or queen and other members of the royal family to speak to a broad range of guests from all walks of life, all of whom have made a positive impact in their community. And then the last event that comes with this mod is a royal wedding. Wedding bells. The monarchy must have declared approval for a royal wedding. Get ready to attract media coverage and international attention when you throw this wedding event. That's cool. I'm excited to do that too. So those are all the events, and we did get to cover most of what is in the mod. And now I am going to add the royalty mod by Lazy Neef in my game, and we're gonna see if these two mods are compatible. All right, so I now have both the royalty mod by Lazy Neef and the royal family mod by Kiera, both in my game. I just went ahead and went into create a sim and gave Amira the monarch trait that comes with the royalty mod by Lazy Neef. I'm gonna say the creator name after just so no one gets confused, but I have given her the monarch mod and she also, or the, sorry, the monarch trait, and she still has the queen trait from the Royal Family mod by Kiera. So in general, for both mods, because so far it seems to be working fine, the only thing I can imagine that would conflict is the titles. I will say the royalty mod is a bit friendlier with the titles. There are more options and there is also changeable and customizable titles. But other things that are included in the royalty mod by Lazy Neef are the adored and despised based on your monarch's interactions with their world. Heirs are technically in both of them, but they work a little bit differently for each of them. There's a tax system in the royalty mod by Lazy Neef. And then of course we have nobility. There's servants as well. You can have like a royal nanny. You can have royal advisors. That's another thing too. And you can assign them tasks. Other features are a few events. So the royalty mod by Lazy Neef also has a coronation event, but they have other things like a royal audience. But yes, there are those differences. Okay, so something I want to see, this will probably mess something up, but for the royalty mod by Lazy Neef, it works a little bit differently for the titles. I can change the titles here. There's this object in build by mode, and it is how you give a lot of the titles. Okay, so Amira Monarch titles. Let's just give her, so she's queen right now, and if I hover over her, it does have the queen title above her name. So let's give her the queen regnant title, queen regent title. Okay, I got a, that there might be a conflict with that, which would make sense. It does look like technically they both work together, like with, you can have the both traits, like the monarch trait that's required for the royalty mod in order for the monarch to do certain things. You can also have the king and queen trait, but definitely cannot give a sim who has been given a title another title with the other mod. So it is really up to you if you want to have both mods in your game, and they both pretty much offer different things. But yeah, I just wanted to test it out and see. So that is it for today's mod review of the Royal Family mod by Kiera Sims 4 Mods. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure you hit that like button if this video was helpful. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you have not already, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!